should be a parabolic profile. So for that, what we need to do, before doing that, you go to pressure, and this is the pressure profile. You can see at the inlet pressure is higher. I have started from 50 and went up to 0. So initially you can see it is in red, that means starting from 50 and going to 0. So linearly, not exactly linear, but it is gradually decreasing and becoming 0. Something else, then also you can plot to expand the velocity or pressure, whatever. This is a surface plot. Now there is an option spf.u in setting window. If you see, there is an option called expression, and under expression it is written spf.u. Did everybody get it? Spf.u. What does it mean? It is, I have plotting the at the right corner, you have one option. If you go there, it is showing hipless expression. At the right corner of this expression, if you touch your cursor, it is showing hipless expression. Click on it. One window will be opened, and there are several options, like you have laminar flow. The physics which we just solved, you expand laminar flow, okay? Then under this you have last option, velocity and pressure, you expand it, okay? Now under velocity you have, under velocity field you have u velocity, v velocity and w velocity. That means u component of velocity, v component of velocity, that means x component, y component and z component. We don't have any z component, so if I choose w, just choose w velocity field, click on it, and then go to the top corner, below setting, where it is written setting, below that there is an option plot, so click on it. Everybody got 0? should not be any W component, and this is the case to show that one only I selected the W component. Again you can change and look for other properties. Suppose under velocity and pressure you choose pressure, that is the same thing. In pressure for initial equality control form, it is the surface control form. So whatever property control has for, you can visually see by changing the expression. There is an option, distance expression equal to under lateral velocity and velocity and pressure. Now you go to data set. There is one option, data set. Under result, the next option is data set. And just below the result, you click on data set. Clear? Right click on it. Right click on data set. From the name itself, you can understand what would be the function of this data set. Basically, I am looking for the data files and plotting. So, under data set, you choose cut line 2D and click on it. Right click on data set, you will have several options. Out of that, one option is the cut line 2D. Everybody, click. So once you click on this data set, you have in the setting window, you have some coordinate options. 2 points, it is automatically shown in 2 points, and coordinate of 2 points, COMSOL is asking for, right? So what it means, suppose I take 1 point here, another point here. So if I join it, I will have a line. I want to show you how the velocity is varying here. So I take one cut line here, anywhere in between the inlet and outlet. So it is varying from 0 to how much? 1.5 into 10 to the power minus 4 or 0 to 150 micrometer. So let us take at 75 micrometer. So you write 75 within bracket, you write UN. Your x here also 75 UL, and y will vary from it was 0 to 30 micrometer. So why you start from 0 and it will be going up to 30 micrometer. So why I start from 0 and keep make it 30 within bracket UM. Okay. Then click on plot. You will have a flat line. Now, one more thing, just for information. Initially, the unit was in meter, 24, the unit was shown in meter. But forcefully, what I did, I put one start bracket, which is the I got UM. So, meter I am changing it to UM. So, you don't need to change the meter from the main window. You can anywhere. Now, so what I choose? I choose the cut line in between the inlet and the outlet. Now, you have one, there is one option called data set. Okay. So, under this data set, there is a drop down menu. If you click on it, there is only one option, none and study mode. Another thing is, you can write it in your notebook. Under self-simulation, you can have several studies. You can have study 1, study 2, study 3, okay. So, when you have more than one study, in this drop-down menu, all the studies will be shown. Suppose, first simulation you need for, say, you can prepare for second simulation, you can prepare another study and do it for, say, 70%. So, what you will be doing like this, so you will have all the study options. Now, suppose you want to plot this velocity profile for the study one option, then from the drop down we have option to simulate that. But as of now we have already done one simulation, one study, that is why only one option is so. Maybe next time I will show you parametric study and two or more studies together. So for the time being you choose the study one, solution one option. Then again go to result, click on result, then right click on result. You have several options, out of that you choose 1D plot view. Okay, go to result, right click on it. Now, under 1D plot view, in the setting window, you go to the top portion, there is an option data set, right? In data set, you click on the drop down menu, two options are being shown. One is your solution 1, study 1, the next option is cut line 2D. Now, here you choose cut line 2D. The concept is, in cut line 2D, I have kept the data set of solution 1. Now, if I take cut line 2D here in the 1D plot group, then automatically it will start taking the data from this study 1 option. Here, I have taken this cut line 2D, once again I am telling, in cut line 2D, where from the data set would come? It would come from the study one. That means some study has been done, it has created some data set, and I am taking the data set from that study. And when I am taking this 1D plot loop, in 1D plot loop, I choose data from cut line 2D1, that automatically means I am taking the data from study. Now, again right click on cut line 2D, 1D plot loop, and click on line graph. Then right click on 1D plot loop, you will get one option, line graph, click on it. Okay? Then click on plot. If you plot it, you can see a parabolic profile, okay. No, because initial, if you don't have any data, you don't have anything to plot. So here I have simulated, that's why data has been generated. And that data I am just plotting, as in you plot it, you do simulation in MATLAB, take the data file and plot in some other software. So here you don't need to take another software to plot. In which there is a GUI option. So it depends on you, which kind of study you choose. This one is time dependent, you can choose stationary, but some other option, you have several studies like eigenvalue, eigenfrequency studies. There are so many things you cannot learn. If you know 2% of control, that is 9.01. One more thing, basically we have plotted for all the time series. But as I have taken a longer time, so it basically reached the steady state. So actually there are several times. If you go to 1D plot group 3, just click on 1D plot group 3. Then look at steady menu. Okay. There is one option data set. Below that, you have another option time series. There is a time selection. You go to one is what to? Now, from there, if you want to generate the data in another data file and you want to plot it in some other software, so what you need to do, you just go to line graph, click on line graph, okay, then right click on it, okay, click on line graph, then right click on it, you will have an option called add data to export. Everybody got it? Add data to export. Just click on it. Clear? Now, in setting window, you have one option called browse. You browse it and choose the location. For the time being, I am saving it in desktop. Say, write anything, data file. Now, save as type, there are several options, okay. You can save it as a text document, as a .dat file, as a CSV file. CSV file basically means it is a format which can be opened in Excel. So it is better to save it in a CSV file because you can access the data and you can change accordingly, okay. So just click on CSV and then click save. So the third thing we can plot it in Excel, but the purpose is not to plot it in Excel. You can take it in data file and you can be software like ID desktop. But just to show you that we can extract the data file and we can plot it. I have shown in by plotting in Excel, but again I am telling the purpose is not to plot it in Excel. You have to plot it in now. We have to take care of the data, right? So the data
you want to call?